Shalom, brothers and sisters. The title of this video is The True Eternal Living Church of God. Know this to be true. A thief will relinquish all that he or she has stolen, if not while living, then surely in death. The True Eternal Living Church of God, the living congregation or assembly of the Most High, true Israelites from the bloodline of Jacob, son of Isaac and grandson of Abraham. The true people by bloodline or seed line of Jacob, the patriarch, the Israelites whose identity has been hidden for all these centuries and whose identity has been stolen. There is no such thing as spiritual Israelites, as some Christianity church teaches. This is a small account of what was happening during the time of Nehemiah after the walls of Jerusalem were completed. Read the whole chapter and book for greater understanding and knowledge. After the walls were finished, Nehemiah stated in Nehemiah 7 verse 5, "And my Elohim put into my mind to gather together the nobles and the rulers and the people, that they might be reckoned by genealogy. And I found a register of the genealogy of them which came up at the first, and found written therein." This is a list of Israelite descendants that returned to Jerusalem during the Medes and Persians' rule. Nehemiah is going to check them by the register according to their genealogy to make sure they are of the bloodline, because non-Israelites were trying to get position or be part of the living church or true congregation of the Most High. In short, they were trying to steal it as a thief. Nehemiah 7 verse 61, "And these were they which went up also from Temala, Telharesha, Cherub, Adon, and Immer, but they could not show their father's house, nor their seed, whether they were of Israel." Nehemiah went through a long list of genealogy, and at the end we see some could not show their father's house, nor their seed, whether they were of Israel. Back then, color was not needed to destroy the lies of the heathen, because we had records of genealogy. But today, color is used in general sense to destroy the lie of Christianity that show a false white Christ and show truth of Scripture and identify Edom, the thieves of our biblical history. Take a look at some truthful and real historical art. What you have witnessed is art from what is called the Dark Ages. Gee, I wonder why they call it the Dark Ages. It is also known as the Middle Ages, where Israelites actually ruled in Europe during those times. It wasn't until their fall and the rise of the Renaissance that they began to take those black Israelites and make them servants. And then they began to search out in the rest of the world to find the rest of the Israelites to subdue them, because they too knew what the Bible said. If we became righteous and turned to the Most High, their time would end. But if they could keep us in sin, they could continue to rule. They knew this, and they went out and searched for us. Now, Nehemiah 7, verse 64. "These sought their register among those that were reckoned by genealogy, but it was not found, but it was not found. Therefore were they as polluted, put from the priesthood. We see that there were some who could not prove their genealogy and was counted as polluted and kicked out of the priesthood. All ministers preaching the word of the Most High are false preachers if they are not of the bloodline of Israel. Now, although most of us are not Levitical priests, we are priests through Yahawashi. Nehemiah 7, verse 66. The whole congregation together was 40,302,300. The true eternal living church of God. Or congregation in Jerusalem at that time was 42,360. And that was just in Jerusalem. Now, let's ask a few questions because many claim to be the true eternal living church of God. I would recommend that you also watch my videos on Jacob and Esau, past and present, part 1 and 2. These videos will help you to identify and recognize the true Israelite descendants. We will have to use color for the sake of recognizing the truth and truth of Scripture. For this reason, color does matter, but Israelites are all colors because of mixing. Let me say that again so you understand this. Israelites are all colors because of mixing. Yeah, there are some Israelites that look white. There are some people that are black and are not Israelites. This will allow us to diffuse the explosive pack of lies that seek to destroy the souls of the righteous saints of the Most High. Question 1. Who are the Egyptians? The Egyptians are really descendants of Mizraim, the son of Ham, which is the son of Noah. The Most High called the land of Mizraim Egypt, which means house of bondage. And Egypt became the first house of bondage for Israel after the life of Joseph and the Pharaoh he knew. Deuteronomy 5, verse 6. I am Yahweh thy Elohim, which brought thee out of the land of Egypt from the house of bondage. Let's take a closer look at Ham and see what it says. The Zondervan Compact Bible Dictionary. Ham, the youngest son of Noah, born about 96 years before the flood, and one of 8 persons to live through the flood. He is the progenitor of the dark races, not the Negroes. He is the progenitor of the dark races, not the Negroes, but the Egyptians, Ethiopians, Libyans, Canaanites. See Genesis 10:6 through 20. So we see some black people come from Ham, or one of his descendants we read about. The Negro, a different line of black people, didn't come from Ham, but from Shem. They don't tell you that because it would blow a clear hole in their lies about who are the true Israelites. The point here is that the real Egyptians are black and not white or light-skinned Arabs that you see today. Question 2. How could Joseph hide among the Egyptians and not be recognized by his brothers if he and they were white? How could Moses fool Pharaoh if Moses was white? How could Moses perform a miracle by sticking his arm in his cloak and it come out white if he was white? How would that be a miracle? If Miriam was white, Moses' sister, how would the Most High turning her white as snow be a curse to her and for the people to see? If Joseph, Mary, and Christ were white, how could they hide out in Egypt from Herod with those black Hamites? Why was the prophet Simeon in Acts 13:1 called by a nickname nigger, which is nigger? Yeah, it's nigger, which simply means black. Why was Paul thought to be an Egyptian by the chief captain in Acts 21:37 through 39? If he was white. This is just a taste. When it comes to the truth of who the real Israelites are, color does matter color crushes the standing lie that blinds most of Israel, the world, and churches today. The light of truth should be shining bright on common sense in your brain. The Jewish fake imposters pretending to be us are not the bloodline of Jacob. They are Israelis. They are Jewish, pertaining to, but not of. Question 3. Israel is supposed to be on the bottom below the other nations, but yet these fake white Jewish imposters are on top of the world. They own the wealth of the world. They control most major industries and technologies, and they control the most powerful militaries in history. And they are in all the first world nations pulling the puppet strings. Who do they need deliverance from? They don't need deliverance because they are the children of Satan, putting his New World Order plan in motion. They are modern day Rome, iron and clay. Question 4. What people fit the curses of Deuteronomy chapter 28, especially verse 68? The Negro fit those curses like a glove. We have been sent to every nation on earth and built their nations with our labor as slaves, because we would not serve the Most High with all joyfulness and gladness of heart. Question 5. What people as a nation don't know where they came from, or know their history, or know what language they spoke? The Negro. The scripture said we would be destroyed and not remember our past as a nation. That's in Deuteronomy 28:48. Question 6. Who are the biggest sellers of military arms around the world? This chart says it all. The Bible don't say Israel will be powerful like this in the last days or any time prior to the last days. Look at these other Edomite nations and how powerful they are. They are not Israel. They all have some of us Israelites living in them, though. We look like people from all around the world. We look like the Chinese, but primarily we are dark-skinned, pushed back into the back end of that nation and all these other nations hidden from the eyes of television. Now, this is a prophecy against Mount Seir, a mountain in Idumea, the land that the Most High gave Esau, the land of his descendants, Edom. This is a dual prophecy of the past and present. Ezekiel 35, verse 1. Moreover, the word of Yahweh came unto me, saying, Son of man, set thy face against Mount Seir, and prophesy against it, and say unto it, Thus says Yah the Most High, Behold, O Mount Seir, I am against thee, and I will stretch out my hand against thee, and I will make thee most desolate. The Most High made Esau and Edom desolate. Malachi 1, verse 3. And I hated Esau and laid his mountains and his heritage waste for the dragons of the wilderness. Whereas Edom saith, We are impoverished, but we will return and build the desolate places. Thus saith Yahweh of hosts, They shall build, but I will throw down. And they shall call them the border of wickedness. And they shall call them the border of wickedness, and the people against whom Yahweh hath indignation forever. And the people against whom Yahweh hath indignation forever. Edom came out of the Caucasus Mountains. Bulan was a Khazar king who led the conversion of the Khazars to Judaism. Khazaria under King Bulan stole a way of life, paganized it, and their descendants continued and prospered in their stolen identity during the Renaissance period after some of the Israelites ruled Western Asia and Europe during the Middle Ages. That's right, blacks, Moors, which mean black, ruled during the Dark Ages and were taken down because they were wicked. These Negroes that ruled Europe during the Dark Ages were wicked. Check out some of the evidence. Now, I'm going to show you that we, Israel, was dead in a metaphoric way, and that we were brought back to life by Yahweh to once again be the true, eternal, living church of God, the living congregation of God, or the living assembly of God. It all means the same. We're going to go through Ezekiel chapter 37 and see the dead come to life, the valley of dry bones. Ezekiel 37, verse 1. The hand of Yahweh was upon me and carried me in the spirit of Yahweh and set me down in the midst of the valley, which was full of bones. Ezekiel is having a vision. And caused me to pass by them round about, and behold, there were very many in the open valley, and lo, they were very dry. There was no living water in us, nothing of substance that caused us to live. We were sin. We were completely in sin. And he said unto me, Son of man, can these bones live? And I answered, O Lord Almighty, thou knowest. And he said unto me, Prophesy upon these bones, and say unto them, O ye dry bones, hear the word of Yahweh. We are now able to hear the word of Yahweh as we seek him in righteousness. Thus saith the Most High unto these bones, Behold, I will cause breath to enter into you, and ye shall live. And I will lay sinews upon you, and will bring up flesh upon you, and cover you with skin, and put breath in you, and ye shall live, and ye shall know that I am Yahweh. The Most High is causing all this awakening and understanding. He is giving us substance with the ability to stand and receive the breath, which is his Holy Spirit. And by this, we know that he is Yahweh. So I prophesied, and I was commanded. And as I prophesied, there was a noise, and behold, a shaking. And the bones came together, bone to his bone. And when I beheld, lo, the sinews and the flesh came up upon them, and the skin covered them above, but there was no breath in them. Ezekiel is getting the full visual representation of this prophecy. There was no breath in us because we lacked knowledge and understanding, as he began to see us rise from being spiritually dead. Then said he unto me, Prophesy unto the wind, prophesy, son of man, and say unto the wind, Thus saith the Most High, Come from the four winds, O breath, and breathe upon these slain, that they may live. So I prophesied as he commanded me, and the breath came into them, and they lived, and stood up upon their feet, an exceeding great army. The breath of the Most High, which is his Holy Spirit, has entered into us today. And we are now becoming that exceeding great army. We still have a short ways to go. Many still have to rise. Then he said unto me, Son of man, these bones are the whole house of Israel. Behold, they say, Our bones are dried, and our hope is lost. We are cut off from our parts. Therefore prophesy and say unto them, Thus saith the Most High, Behold, O my people, I will open your graves, and cause you to come up out of your graves, and bring you into the land of Israel. These graves are real and metaphoric, because this prophecy is for now and the near future, speaking of the resurrection. Some of us Israelites are and were in metaphoric graves, being dead spiritually. Other Israelites in Christ that have died are in actual graves. And ye shall know that I am Yahweh when I have opened your graves, O my people, and brought you up out of your graves, and shall put my spirit in you, and ye shall live, and I shall place you in your own land. Then shall ye know that Yahweh have spoken it and performed it, saith Yahweh. We know he is Yahweh because he has awakened us, and many of us have grown tremendously in the spirit and word. We are alive now and no longer dead to who we are and where our home is and the facts of our true history. The word of Yahweh came again unto me, saying, Moreover, thou son of man, take thee one stick, and write upon it for Judah, and for the children of Israel his companions. Then take another stick, and write upon it for Joseph, the stick of Ephraim, and for all the house of Israel his companions. And join them one to another into one stick, and they shall become one in thine hand. And when the children of thy people shall speak unto thee, saying, Wilt thou not show us what thou meanest by these? These two sticks are northern kingdom Ephraim and southern kingdom Judah. They are being joined back into a single house, the whole house of Israel. I profess it, and you see it in my logo. Say unto them, Thus saith the Most High, Behold, I will take the stick of Joseph, which is the hand of Ephraim, and the tribes of Israel, his fellows, and will put them with him, even with the stick of Judah, and make them one stick, and they shall be one in my hand. And the sticks whereon thou writest shall be in thy hand before their eyes. And say unto them, Thus saith the Most High, Behold, I will take the children of Israel from among the heathen, whether they be gone, and will gather them on every side, and bring them into their own land. And I will make them one nation in the land upon the mountains of Israel, and one king shall be king to them all, and they shall be no more two nations, neither shall they be divided into two kingdoms any more at all. This process is almost complete. We will truly be one nation, Israel, under the Most High, with Christ or Yahawashi as our King. Neither shall they defile themselves any more with their idols, nor with their detestable things, nor with any of their transgressions, but I will save them out of all their dwelling places, wherein they have sinned, and will cleanse them. So shall they be my people, and I will be their Elohim. Yahweh will cleanse Israel. Then we will turn to the nations during the 1,000 years. My tabernacle also shall be with them. Yea, I will be their Elohim, and they shall be my people. And the heathen shall know that I, Yahweh, do sanctify Israel, when my sanctuary shall be in the midst of them forevermore. You see, the nations are still separate from us because we are sanctified. The sanctuary of Yahweh will be among us, Israel, forever. We know that Edom and the nations wanted to destroy us from being a nation, killing us in a sense. They could not and cannot kill us. We are too many and protected. We are the true eternal living church of God and cannot die. Others claim to be the true eternal living church of God, but they are dead. They are slowly dying like an old vine because there is no truth in them. They deceive themselves just as they have in the past because they can't admit who Yahweh's true people are and seek to steal what's not theirs. The true eternal living church of God was living during the time of King David and Solomon. But then, through sin, Israel died a slow death that led to the curses being poured out on them for over 2,500 years, from Daniel's time to the present time. We became hidden in the earth because the nations had an agreement to make the name of Israel or true Israelites no more. Psalms 83, verse 3. They have taken crafty counsel against thy people, and consulted against thy hidden ones. They have said, Come, let us cut them off from being a nation, that the name of Israel be no more in remembrance. In slavery, everything was taken away from us. The knowledge of who we are, our language, where we originated from, our heritage, our God, and more. Nothing like this has been done to any other people in history, except black people or Israelites that went into slavery all over the world. A sign was given in Deuteronomy 28:68 about the final captivity of Judah, which would go into slavery by ships. We're the only people that fit that. The Most High has begun to restore the scattered and dry bones of his people. He has awakened the sleeper. He has removed the scales from the eyes of the hidden ones and brought us to light, and has breathed his breath into our bodies, which is his Holy Spirit. We now live. We are the living church, the living congregation, the living people of Yahweh. We are Israel, the rod of iron by which Yahusha will rule the nations. We prepare ourselves in these final years as the angels hold back the four winds in Revelation 7:1-4, and his wrath is rolled out in the heavens, and this earth, which began in September 2017, Revelation 12:1-2, and will end 7 years later in the fall of 2024. All of the imposters of the Most High's people should repent and yield to the truth and pray that the Most High will be merciful for touching the apple of his eye. There is only the true, eternal, living church of God, and they are Israelites and not Israeli. They are primarily so-called black and not so-called white. They are of low stature around the world with no power and not ruling the nations, and are hated of all nations. As an Israelite, I speak the truth, and in the deepest part of your heart or your mind, you know what I'm saying is true. Look around the world and watch the intensity of the first four seals increase. 2020 will be far worse than this year, and this year isn't over yet. Most people don't have a clue to what's really happening, but if you are listening to me now, you have a clue. You are in the know. You know that we are the living church of the Most High. We are the living church of God, and that we are back and we are rising. Praise Yahweh. Shalom.